Welcome to another inspiring review, guys. Today I'm going to be reviewing a couple of pieces of hardware which I've upgraded on my new PC. First of all, we're going to the Core 2 Duo from Intel, the 45nm processor. It's an E8400, the E0 stepping though, which is a fantastic overclocker, I must say. It performs a lot better than my QX 6700. And also, the Sapphire 4870 X2. The reason why it took me a while to put this video up on YouTube, guys, is because of this video card. It's given me nothing but problems. I thought it was a hardware problem, so I RMA'd my first one, and this is my second one now. And I chucked it back into my system, and I realized it's not a hardware problem. It's actually a software problem, which is a driver issue. Because most of my games, just won't work with this card at the moment. Having a lot of crashing problems. Anyway, regardless, it's still a very good card. It does perform very well here when it does work well. But I've only got one for now. I'm not going to bother with two, guys. It's because the drivers are just very bad at the moment. I'm just going to settle by having one. Anyway, let's just go through what I've done so far. I've got a few tweaks. I've actually, the CPU is running at 4.5 gigahertz at 500 FSB, front side bus, so effectively 2000 megahertz, which is an incredible speed, honestly. It just overclocks the really well with the CPU. And the core voltage is at 1.425 volts, which is very good. And there you see there, guys, the temperatures, it's at idle at the moment. It's 32 for both cores. And on load, they don't go past 60. I've actually been stressing that all night, and it's rock solid stable at that speed, which I'm very happy about. I'm just over the moon about that. 4.5 gigahertz, guys. That's just, that's awesome to me. Also, what I've done with the Sapphire 4870 X2 card is I flashed it to the Asus top BIOS, which comes with a 790 core clock standard and a 915 megahertz on the memory I'm standing out of the factory, and it does perform a lot better with that BIOS, and it works really well with the Sapphire card, so I'm quite happy with that. Turned out really well. Also, what I've done inside the case, guys, I made some changes. I've actually put the radiator, because remember on part two, I actually had the inlet and the outlet tubes on the other side. I've actually turned the radiator on this side now, with the pipes on this side. And then, as you can see, guys, it's a bit neater, and it's a shorter path into the CPU, which is good. And what else can I show you, guys? Yeah, I've actually mounted this on now. Just put two screws in there and bolted it on nicely. I put some padding underneath the pump, so it won't vibrate on the case, which is good. You don't hear it at all. That's pretty much it, guys. Now, what I'm doing, I'm just going to run a quick mark on 3DMark 06 here, just to show you the performance of this PC, basically what you can do with 1 4870 X2. Fortunately, it is working well with the 3DMark 06, so I'm going to chuck it on here right after you guys. So, guys, we're just on the last run there on 3DMark 06. Also, I forgot to mention, I've actually changed my Northbridge block. I had an old SwiftTech block, you can see that there. And I've actually changed it to the SwiftTech one, because the one that Asus here provides just comes with small inlet pipes, and I just don't like it. It sort of, the flow is not as good as this one. And it has dropped the temperatures by about 4 degrees, which is fantastic, on the Northbridge. Just on the last loop now.
look and see what we've got. $21,407. That's not bad, guys. That's not bad at all. That's a dual core CPU, but it's running at 4.5 gigahertz. That's a great score. So you can imagine what two 4870X2s would do. That's just one. But still, great score.